Hello everyone, well this is it, the winter 2012-2013 NAO forecast from GazWeatherVids.com. Now I've got a lot to get through in this video, so my advice to you is to get a cup of tea, get a biscuit and a comfortable chair, because we've got a lot to talk about that's going to go on for quite some time. Now I've got a very croaky voice, I've got a bit of a sore throat, so I've got my water with me. At any point I may have to stop and have a sip of water, so I hope you will bear with me if I have to do that. Now, before I get on with the video, I just want to talk about the advertising on GazWeatherVids.com. There will usually be a video ad overlaying my web videos. Please play those video ads because you'll be supporting GazWeatherVids.com if you do this. Now the first thing I want to talk about is what the NAO actually is, because I understand that there's a lot of people watching this video probably don't have much understanding about the North Atlantic Oscillation. The first thing I want to say is that the North Atlantic Oscillation is just really an index that reflects the state of the Atlantic, and we look at the differential in pressure between Iceland up here and the Azores down here. Now when the index is positive, that's telling us that Atlantic is in a westerly phase. Really, we'll have high pressure around the Azores, we'll have low pressure around Iceland, and the winds will be westerly. Now, the more intense the index, the stronger the NAO, then the stronger the westerly winds are. But it's the westerly winds that are driving the NAO. It's the weather that's driving the NAO. It's not the NAO that's driving weather. A lot of people talk about the NAO as though it's a driver of the weather. It isn't a driver of the weather, because the NAO goes positive or negative. That is not driving the weather. It's the weather that is driving the index. Now this is from the 25th of December 2011, it's a very good example of a positive NAO, because we've got the low pressure around Iceland, around Greenland, very intense area of low pressure up there, a strong polar vortex, and we've got high pressure around the Azores going in towards France and Spain and Portugal, and we've got these westerly winds blasting right way from Canada all the way towards Russia, right way across the Atlantic and Europe. So that's a very good example of a positive NAO, very positive NAO actually that would have been, because the westerly winds are really quite strong and intense. As I say, it is the westerly winds with setup that's driving the NAO, it's not the other way round. This is another very good example of a positive NAO. This is from the 15th of January 1989, and we have a high pressure set up there around Spain and into France. We've got the westerly wind going across the country. We've got low pressure up around Iceland and into Greenland as well. And we have got those westerly winds coming across the Atlantic and into Europe. Now, a great example of a negative NAO is this one from the 17th of December 2010. We've got high pressure going up towards Greenland and we've got low pressure around the Azores. So this is a completely different setup to the positive NAO setup. This is a complete switch around, a complete reversal, as you would expect, really. From a negative NAO, you expect the situation to be completely different. It is. We've got high pressure there blocking around Greenland. We've got the low pressure in the Azores. And instead of pulling in a westerly wind, we're pulling down this northerly wind across the British Isles. And this was a very cold setup, of course, for much of Northern Europe. And then again, as we go to the 27th of December 1962, again, a very good example of a negative NAO. We've got the blocking area of high pressure up around Greenland and Iceland. We've got the low pressure going through the Azores. We're pulling in this very cold air across most of the European continent. So as I say, the NAO, the North Atlantic Oscillation, is reflecting, or it's an index that reflects the atmospheric setup. It isn't a driver of the setup. Now, the reason we use the sea surface temperature anomalies in the Atlantic in May is that they do have a tendency, those sea temperature anomalies in May, to recur once we get through to the winter. And the reason for this is not clearly understood, but it's one of the common occurrences, but does happen that the sea surface temperature anomalies in May do tend to come back in winter. So if we're looking for a negative NAO in winter, this is the kind of setup that we're looking for in May in terms of the sea temp, sea surface temperature. Excuse me, the sea surface temperature anomalies in May. So we've got the positive anomaly here down in the tropical Atlantic. We've got the negative anomaly through the mid-Atlantic, and particularly centered around the eastern seaboard of the United States. And then we've got another positive anomaly around Greenland, just to the south of Greenland. This is the tripole, and as I say, we've got the warm, cold and warm band going on there. And if we get that in May, then that is a good indication, or it can be a good indication, that come the winter, the coming winter, that will reoccur, and the NAO will consequently be negative, because that would imply a blocking area of high pressure up around Greenland and low pressure tracking to the south of that blocking area of high pressure, and a weakened Azores High. If that happens, the NAO is negative, of course. And again, this is another example from a past year of May sea surface temperature anomaly that is conducive to a negative NAO forecast for the coming winter. And again, we see the warm temperature anomalies through the tropical Atlantic. We see that cooler, colder band up there through the middle of the Atlantic, and particularly again centered around the eastern seaboard of the United States and Newfoundland. And again, we have the warm band of water there through to the south of Greenland. So again, we've got the tripole, the warm, cold and warm signal. And again, that would lead us to forecast a negative NAO for the coming winter. And indeed, of course, we have that superbly cold December across Europe that was the result of this. And finally, for the negative NAO examples from May 1995, we've got a slightly different setup here. The warmer band is actually a little bit further north with this, but it's still very warm through the tropical Atlantic. We've still got the cold band around the eastern seaboard of the States and around Newfoundland. And if you ignore this area of blue here to the west of Greenland, if you ignore that, you should ignore that, we're basically looking at a warm band again going on to the south of Greenland. So again, we've really got the warm, cold and warm band. And again, this did lead the Met Office actually to forecast a negative NAO for the coming winter, and we did have a negative NAO for winter of 95-96. Now, if you're looking for May sea surface temperature anomaly that's likely to lead to a positive NAO, then this example from 2002 is a good example, because we've got the cool waters here through the tropical Atlantic, cooler than average temperature anomalies there through the tropical Atlantic sea surface temperature anomalies. We've got the warmer band up here to the north of that, and then we've got a cool band to the south of Greenland. So this is really the opposite of the negative NAO examples. This is the opposite of that, and would lead us to conclude, or certainly did lead the Met Office to conclude, that winter was likely to be positive. NAO was likely to be positive through that winter, and indeed for the winter of 2002-2003 did have a largely positive NAO. Again, 2006, we've got at near normal temperature anomalies through the Atlantic, the tropical Atlantic I should say. To the north of that, we've got warm waters around Newfoundland and going up towards Greenland, so there's no tripod here. And again, this would lead us to conclude that the NAO is likely to be positive through the coming winter. That was the forecast from the Met Office, and that did occur. And now we're going to go on and have a look at the temperature anomalies for this month of May 2012, and we're going to attempt to use those temperature anomalies to come up with a forecast for the NAO for the winter of 2012-2013. So this is the first temperature anomaly for the Atlantic Ocean for the 7th of May 2012. And what we're looking at here is average or cool temperature anomalies really through the tropical Atlantic, warmer waters centered to the north around Newfoundland and going up towards Greenland. But to the far south of Greenland, the water is actually a little bit cooler. I've also got this cool anomaly up here to the north of Scotland and around between Iceland and Scandinavia. So if we go further on, have a look at how those temperature anomalies progress through the course of May, where we keep the cooler waters going through the tropical Atlantic. There's no sign of any warm band occurring here, and the temperature anomalies actually increase around Newfoundland. So we're actually bringing up, we've actually got warmer temperature anomalies here around the eastern seaboard, the northeastern seaboard, I should say, of the United States, and stretching out into the mid-Atlantic. A little bit of warm water occurring here off the coast of Iberia, but really the tropical Atlantic is quite cool. And then going on to the 31st of May, so this is the final chart that we're interested in for the May 2012. Again, it's a very similar situation. No sign of any warmer waters occurring through the Atlantic. The temperature anomaly through the tropical Atlantic is average to cool, and further north I've got that warm water still around Newfoundland, and maybe a little bit of cooler water occurring into occur in the mid-Atlantic. So really what we're looking at with this is that this is very much signaling that the temperature anomaly is likely to be cool through the tropical Atlantic through the course of May. It has been cool, and it's warmer further north. And the consequence of that for the winter North Atlantic Oscillation forecast for 2012-2013 is that we are likely to see a positive NAO through the course of the coming winter. We haven't got the tripod, we haven't got the band, the warm, cold, warm band that we would look for to have a negative NAO through the course of 2012-2013. This is indicating that the North Atlantic Oscillation is likely to be positive. Now, I realise that a lot of people viewing this video are going to be disappointed at that, because a lot of people like cold winds, certainly weather fans, and I assume weather fans are mainly going to be viewing this video, they like cold winters, and I understand that a lot of people will be disappointed at this. So what I would say is that this is quite experimental, it's not certain, and there are a lot of other things that we look at that are even more important really than the setup in the Atlantic in May. We look at the sea ice extent through the course of the summer, how that plays out through the summer. We look at how quickly the snow cover builds up over Siberia. We look at the ENSO, the El Nino or the La Nina that might be occurring in any given year. So there's a lot of other things that play, solar activity, something else we look at. There's a lot of other things we look at to make a winter forecast. This is just one element within that forecast, although the Met Office certainly did use to treat this as quite an important element for sea surface temperature anomalies in May. And one other crumb of comfort that I've come up with is that the closest anomaly that I've found is actually with 2000. The anomaly this month is very close, the sea surface temperature anomaly in the Atlantic this month is actually very close to May 2000. This is the sea surface temperature anomaly from Uniseas.com from May 2000. Notice that warm area to the west of Newfoundland, to the east of Newfoundland, I should say, and the cooler waters here stretching through the Atlantic and up towards the British Isles, and then further north in towards Iceland. So we've got the cooler band here through the tropical Atlantic, the warmer band above it. Now go on to the temperature anomaly for this month, and it's very similar. We've got the cool waters there through the tropical Atlantic going up to the British Isles, but massive warm of cool water there, and then we've got the warm waters above it. This is the closest I could find to the setup this month was May 2000, and May 2000 did leave the Met Office to forecast a very positive NAO for the winter of 2000-2001, and when all was said and done, the NAO actually came out below, actually came out negative. So it just goes to show you that things aren't are likely to change. I would have liked to have shown you some Met Office charts of this, but I was unable to. The Met Office told me that I'd have to pay £75 to use any of their NAO data, so I wasn't able to do that. But the NAO was negative through the winter of 2000-2001, despite the setup through May 2000 being very conducive. Let's have a look at it again. Being very conducive to a negative, to a positive NAO forecast. We did forecast a positive NAO. It didn't happen. The NAO was negative. Of course, we had a very, very wet autumn. And there is some speculation, has been some speculation, that very wet autumn did lead to a much more negative NAO than the Met Office predicted. But in any case, to summarise, to sum this video up, the sea surface temperature anomalies in May 2012 are indicating that we are likely to see a positive NAO through the winter of 2012-2013. Now, we've got to go away through the summer, enjoy the summer. We've got to come back in September and start looking at all the other things that I was talking about, the ice extent, the Siberian snow cover, and various other things, and we'll have a look at to how those things progress through the course of the autumn. So if you want a cold winter, don't worry about this too much. There's still a lot to play for. But as I say, the May 2012 Atlantic Ocean setup is inducive to a positive NAO for the coming winter. That's all for now.